And I just wanted to talk a little bit about my life as a military brat growing up with a military background.
Can y'all hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay. Well, my dad was in the military for about 30 years, just recently retired in 2012, so I've been all over the place from outside the United States to inside the United States. One question that I dread getting from a lot of people is like, where are you from? I don't really know how to tell you where I'm from because I've been all over. Most likely, if you ask me, probably going to tell you Texas because that's where I've lived the longest. I've lived in a whole bunch of different places, starting with New Jersey. I don't really remember anything about that. As a baby at the time, I just know that's where my brother was born. Lived in Japan, Italy, Japan again, Virginia, Alabama, and Texas. Virginia was kind of like me getting to the back into the swing of things and getting started with, I guess, the American culture because I'd been overseas for so long. And currently when I visit home, I go to Texas. And then some of the best memories from where I've lived, since we're all med students, I wanted to like throw in animal-related stuff, so I put pictures of all my dogs. It's my first body that I got in Japan. So that's my first body that I got in Japan. His name is Sloan. My Shiba eating mix, Poppy, I got my second time when I was in Japan. In the middle, my Yorkie, Kima, she currently lives in Texas. The Roddy on the end was my second Roddy, Tino, I got in Texas, yeah. And then the little pit bull puppy is my dog, Raja, which she currently lives with my ex now, because she's doing well. She's a lot bigger. Just do that in there for laughs. Okay. And then, I'm not really going to say what that says, but you can read it. It's kind of an inside joke because my Yorkie, she has accidents sometimes, and so my sister calls her crappy and crappy. I'm not going to say it. Yeah, okay. So, what I like about Italy, the food is really good there. It's nice to have authentic Italian pizza and gelato. The language I thought was really beautiful. I don't really know how to speak full Italian. I know bits and pieces or some words. It's a lot similar to Spanish, but I think it might be a little harder to pick up than Spanish. They have carnival there, like how here in St. Kitts, they have carnival where they dress up in masquerade masks and go and do parades throughout the city. And then the weather there is great. You get all four seasons, unlike here in Texas where it's like summer year. What I love about Japan, Japan was one of my favorite places to live. The food was really good. The weather was great. There's lots to do. You can go to the movies, you can go to the music parks, you can go to the mall. And the people there were extremely friendly, especially living on base, on a military base. I kid you not. There would be people that would come from off base when I lived in Japan, and they'd come up to me and my family and be like, oh, you're cute Americans, can we take pictures of you? And we're like, what? But it was really fun. You kind of feel like a celebrity out there. And these are just pictures of the different things that I liked about Italy and Japan. This picture over here on the left-hand side, that's Keiji World, it's an indoor water park in Japan. That's a picture from Carnival. There's also Tokyo Disneyland, which is a lot of fun. I went there maybe twice. Mr. Donut is one of the best donut places ever. I'd say it's about as good as Dunkin' Donuts, which is one of my favorite donut shops. And then I threw that picture in there because a lot of people have this stereotype that I guess women in Japan dress in like the vibrant colors and walk around like colorful all over the streets, but that's not true. They dress just like us. The only time I ever see or ever saw them dressed like that was during parades or like community events. Most of the time, they're just in formal clothes. And that last picture was a picture of Tokyo that night. And these are just other pictures of some of the other foods that I
really enjoyed, real bold. That was a really good energy drink. I like crack. It's like Red Bull, or the equivalent to Red Bull is really good. And then on the end, it's like a sour gummy. I don't know what it's called, but it was really good. Yakisoba is kind of like chow mein, but better in my opinion. It's really good. If you ever get anyone to like make that for you, have it like authentically made. Because I've had like the boxed yakisoba that you get at like the grocery store. It's not as good. And these are just other pictures of other amusement parks that I've had the pleasure of going to while my dad has been in the military, like SeaWorld, Busch Gardens, Six Flags, and King's Dominion. So you get to go to a lot of different attractions. And then Disney World, MGM Studios, and then one of my favorite rides is Space Mountain at Disney World. Common misconceptions. One of the main things that I felt like, I guess, was the biggest misconception is that a lot of people think when you're living overseas and you're living, just living overseas in general in the military, that you go to a school where it's just predominantly, like when you live in Japan, a lot of people thought that I went to school with just Japanese people. And they're like, well, did you pick up on a language? Are you fluent in a language? Like, no. I went to school on a military base, so it was a very Americanized school. And they're really big on education, I feel like, overseas when you're living on a military base. Pros of the military. That's my best friend, her daughter. She wanted me to like put her in my presentation somehow. There's a lot of fun events that happen off base that gets the community together, like cook-offs and a lot of fun like dance-offs, community events. Like I said, education is key. I know in Japan, when we lived overseas, a lot of the Japanese schools, they went to school Monday through Saturday. So like we had Sunday off, but they were like, yeah, they were like really focused on education, which I feel like is a good thing. It's kind of living on base. Yeah, living on base is kind of like a home away from home. So you never got homesick living like out there. You never felt like, oh, I kind of miss living back in Texas, or oh, I miss living back in Virginia, because everything was kind of right there on base. So I never really got homesick. The only hard thing about the military, I guess it falls under my cons, is having to move every 2 to 3 years. So once you've made that like forever friend and then you had to up and leave again, that was the only downside to it. Other than that, it was good. Base housing was kind of small, but I didn't really care about that. Lack of privacy. If you ever got into any type of trouble or anything and didn't want anybody to know, somebody's gonna find out. Somebody is going to tell somebody else, and then it's going to get to somebody who's in charge of your dad, and then it's going to get to your dad. So I guess the best thing is like not to keep things secret. It's helped me to, or what I've learned about, I guess, growing up with a military lifestyle, it's helped me to adapt and to become accepting to other cultures and to have an open mind to different things. And it's also, I guess it's broadened my horizons in a lot of ways. Instead of being just stuck in one place at one or at one time for my whole life, it's nice to kind of see different people's experiences. And then I guess the only downside after the military, there's no more perks. With the military, you have a lot of things that you get discounted or that are covered. Like going to the movies, I know that used to be cheaper for me. Like, back home, like in Texas, it's like $8 to $12 to go to the movies, but with the military, it'd be like $6.50 to go to the movies, and you get discounts at stores and the mall and stuff, and then also having your dental and medical and all this other stuff covered as well. So that was nice. But other than that, you end up finding forever friends once your parents or whatever have retired, and it's easier to stay connected to extended family versus like living out of the country and then trying to stay connected with people in the States through phone call or email. And it's less expensive to travel, unless of course you're coming here. So. When I first got out here, I thought, oh yeah, I got this. I've lived out of the country before, I'll be good. But it was a lot harder than I thought it would be. I guess because I'm like spoiled. So it was a lot harder than I thought it would be, especially not bringing a significant other family out here. So it taught me to, like, I guess, be stronger living out here. And there was times where I'd go through, oh, I love it, and times where I hated it, and now I'm content. And I've gotten involved with more organizations here at school. So it's helped me to, like, yeah, just stay focused here. Should I join? I'm not sure if I want to join yet. I've thought about joining the Army because they do have a veterinary corps to help pay back some of these loans, because I don't have money to ball out like I'm Drake. So, yeah, I thought about it, but I'm not exactly sure. I still have to look into it more, and I also love to travel and meet new people and try new things. So. And then this is my little montage to my little brother. I just want to dedicate my presentation to him because he has, for his spirit, don't want to get all religious, but his spirit has helped me get through my time here at Ross. And these are some of his little sayings. Sorry. Some of his sayings he used to say. And so every time I go into an exam, I tell myself, all right, let's get it. You got this. You're going to get that A. And I end up getting an A. So having him watch over me every day while I'm out here, it really has helped me. And I want to end this on a happier note. Anybody have any questions at all? No? Okay, well, thank you. I appreciate your time.